In this session, let us understand and study what is coal handling system that is adopted in thermal power plants. What are coal handling system? The coal handling refers to the process of transferring the coal from the point of unloading to the place of use. Means I'm having coal yards, I will be having coal mines. From that point, I have to get the coal to site. From the site, I have to take it to the up to the furnace or a boiler. That is called as a coal handling system. It is carried out by several means depending upon the requirement of the power plant. It means that I may be getting the coal from within the country, or I may be getting it from across the globe. Means I am getting it from some other country and I am shipping it to the plant. So I may be requiring ship, I may be requiring the railway tracks. So if it is within the state, I want a railway track. If it is brought as from as a foreign coal, I want the certain shipping arrangement. So the important equipment used for the transporting the coal are as follows. That is a belt conveyor, screw conveyor, bucket elevators, grab bucket elevators. So the figure shows the commonly used system that is used in the coal handling system. Belt conveyors. So here the belt conveyor system, you can have the length of the belt very long, and there are this type of arrangement that is called as a skirt rubbers. Skirt rubbers are used, right? It is a skirt rubbers are used in the system. Skirt rubbers are used so that the coal, which is maybe in powder form, is not getting escaped into atmosphere. For that reason, it will be having, and moreover, we will be having the bearings at the bottom. And we will be having shaft at the one end. So here the coal is fed on the conveyor belt and delivers out at the other end. To know the features, the belt conveyors are suitable for transporting large quantity of coal. And here it is endless belt running over a pair of end drums or pulley and supported by a series of rollers at a regular intervals. So these rollers either greased regular pattern so that the conveyor goes in a smooth operation. The belt is usually made of a strong material or from rubber or canvas. So the return idlers which support the empty belt are plain rollers and spaced wide apart. The belt is inclined at about 15 to 20 degrees in a case of coal handling system. Generally 28 or 30 degree is we seen in the theoretically, but people, they don't want to go for up to 30 degree. 15 to 20 degree inclination or 25 degree in other industrial application, but in the coal yard generally it is up to 20 degree inclination. The average speed of the belt conveyor is about 50 to 100 meter per minute. It is used in a medium and a large power plants. The advantages are, it is simple in construction and operation, most economical method of coal transport. It requires less power. If you compare to the screw conveyors or bucket elevators, the power consumption is less over here. The large quantities of coal can be transferred quickly and continuously. So you can have the size of the length of the belt long. So large quantity can be transferred. It is comparatively cheaper in a maintenance and operation. The disadvantages are not suitable for a short distance and a greater heights. So if it is a in the mining station, it cannot be used, right? Because the height will be a bigger parameter and cannot be used for the inclination more than 20 degrees. The second one is screw conveyors. In the screw conveyors, it is similar to something what we see in the present conveyor system of concreting, right? Here you have got a helicoidal shape, and here the bearing, ball bearing, and the gear box method or gear box arrangement will be there with some power supply. So coal is fed over from here and the coal comes out at the other point. So this is generally used where it is somewhat wet, where the coal is wet, and I cannot prefer to have take the risk on that one. So the integral parts of the screw conveyors are shown over here, right? So this is used in a cement industries and some other process industries also. Let us see the features of screw conveyor. It consists of an endless helical screw fitted to a shaft. The driving mechanism is connected to one end of the shaft and other end of the shaft is supported in an enclosed ball bearing. The screw, while rotating in a trough housing, transfers coal from one end to other end. The diameter of the screw varies from 15 cm to 50 cm and its speed varies from 70 to 120 rpm. The screw conveyor is most suitable for the medium scale coal transportation, means it has around 100 to 125 tons of per hour coal can be transferred. The advantages are it is relatively inexpensive, it requires minimum space for operation, it is very simple and compact, it is made of dust tight, so here it is completely enclosed, so risk of wastage of the coal because of the powder has been avoided here to the greater extent. The disadvantages are the power consumption is comparatively high and it is suitable for only short distance transportation, that is around from 20 to 30 meters, surely much lesser than the belt drives. The wear and tear of the parts is more. Moreover, the jamming may take place inside, like the cement industry jamming will be frequent, but here also whenever coal is having little moisture more than recommended, it will get jammed. So sometime jackhammer has to be used to clear the jamming. The next one is a bucket elevator. This is used as a diagram sheet for the height or wherever there is elevation, the bucket elevators are used. So the figure shows the bucket elevator used within the plant, inside the plant, so for the coal handling system. It looks like a pelton wheel bucket, but surely it is not in that shape. So continuous supply at one side and continuous unloading at the other side is possible. Let us see the features of bucket elevator. This type of conveyor is used for moving the coal vertically up. It consists of number of iron bucket fixed on to the chain moving over two wheels as seen in the earlier figure. The coal is carried by the bucket from the bottom and discharged at the top. Usually such conveyor can transport coal to height up to 30 meters and maximum inclination is 60 degrees. The speed of the chain is around 75 meter per minute and can discharge about 60 tons coal per hour. Next one is a grab bucket elevators. What is grab bucket elevators? Here we have got a hoist and bucket. So you might have seen this one. Wherever I have to blend different type of coals, this is a generally used, right? It catch holds the material in its bucket and can be shifted to some other spot. So the main features of the grab bucket elevators are the construction of the grab bucket elevator, as we seen in the earlier figure. It consists of a crane which can lift and transfer the coal from one point to another. Here, the system is suitable for handling coal at the coal storage yard. This elevator has unique advantage of operating as a crane as well as moving in all directions. This helps in lifting the coal using the grab bucket from the yard and changes its direction, move to the required distance and unload it. So the region like Manali hill station, where it is very difficult to have the belt conveyors or screw conveyors, the grab bucket elevator are especially used. The grab bucket with the bottom closed condition picks up the coal from the heap and moved where it is required to be unloaded. The flow of the coal in the power plant, we can see it comes from the storage yard to tipper, and surely it has to be taken to the weighbridge to measure the exact quantity before it is conveyed to the belt conveyor, from the belt conveyor to the crusher, right? It has to be crushed to the required size, then to the separator for different sizing, then separated to belt conveyor once again, or to bucket elevators, then bucket elevator to pulverizer. Pulverizer are, as we studied earlier, to make it to very fine particles in the size of microns. Then pulverized through to bin, then to furnace or a boiler. So the line diagram shows up here. The coal storage yard, from then it is going to the tipper, right? Here it is a weighed, then it is come to the belt conveyor. In the belt conveyor also we should have the magnetic separators, so that if any nails or any magnetic particles are there, it should not enter to the crusher, because it will increase surely increase the tear and wear in the crusher. So the magnetic separators are also incorporated in the belt conveyor. Then from the belt conveyor it come to the crusher, then to the elevator. Of course, it is a bucket elevator, is not a must in every plant, but if it is there, it will be very useful to send to the pulverizing mill. Then it goes to the bin, then to the furnace. This is the normal flow of coal from within the site. That is a coal delivery. Coal delivery means from the, as we discussed earlier, from the coal yard to the site, then unloading, then preparation. Preparation is some manual power is required for the preparation, right? Little bit manpower is surely required to make the lumpy coal to smaller size, then transfer. Outdoor storage, it is been stored in heaps in the coal yards. Many times with the shelter are provided, right? So either outdoor storage or cover storage. And one more important thing has to be noted over here is if it is a very hot summer or the area where it catches fire, the care has to be taken in the cover storage that ice packing can be provided at the bottom of the coal, so that it will not come to its flash and fire point. In plant handling, weighing and measuring, then to the furnace firing. This is connected to the in-plant coal handling system.